Just think, 100 years ago, there was millions of buffalo roaming through here. And we shot them all. I think that's nice. Of course, I'm sitting here wearing a fur coat saying that. We're on our way to Portland and to the first of our North American tour. I know, it's very exciting. It's the first tour we've done in, how long, Paul? How long has it been since we've toured? 10 years?
Yeah, 15 years almost.
15 years?
Yeah.
Has it been that long? I guess it has been.
95 or 6.
Huh?
96. No, 15 years.
15 years.
It's a big rock. It's rock and roll right there. It's weird, it makes you never want to play music again. You know, just being out here. He came to me and Henry one night and said, I want to book a tour. This guy Andrew's already booked some shows. He's got a lot of interest. They're going to pay us a lot of money. He also said that he's very sick. He goes, I'm very sick. I want to do this tour. And so because he was sick and he said this might be the last tour he ever does, I said, okay, let's do it.
Where are you gonna sit?
This is an American rockumentary. Some of my queen friends would be really mortified at what my makeup box looks like right now. I would be shunned from better gay society.
Look at that.
That's all the bad things I've ever done in my life. Trapped under my skin. We should, at one point, like, I should get in a big giant dumpster. And she'd come and like knock on it, okay, it's time for the show. And I'd crawl out of the dumpster. Because, you know, that was the other rumor, is that I was living in LA in a dumpster. That was a good one, I liked that one. Alexis heard I was dead.
We are Psychotica. We haven't done shows in 15 years almost. We're very excited to be back.
Hello! How are you? Have you been all right? All those lonely nights. But I say, I tell you everything. You pick up that
I've been, you know, I was one of those guys once or twice a year, get in line, see if something was happening, nothing, you know, old dead websites, that kind of stuff, and then slowly I would hear, oh, an acoustic show, oh, something's happening, they're back together, what's going on, maybe they're going to go on tour, wouldn't miss it for the world.
You know, after that long of a break, I was concerned they might lose that touch, but it's just, you know, I get goosebumps every time I hear them. I got it right now, just talking about it. I want more. I want to hear them again. I want them to come through again. I want to get a full-length record. Just keep doing it. You know, we love you, and keep touring.
Me up and they said, hey, we're jamming. I go over and this guy was there and I go, who's this? What's this thing? And they go, oh, we're auditioning you. I didn't even play a note. And that guy goes, okay, you're in. The gig's on Friday. Yeah, I thought I was going to jam with my old buddies. But it was some ruse to look for someone to play, I guess. So what happened was as we played and we rehearsed, and then some girl walked by from the record label and heard us play, like our first time we ever rehearsed. And she goes, oh, hi, I'm from American Records. I'd like to sign you. And she signed us because we were all dressed in like ripped jeans and t-shirts, like street guys. And then came to the show and saw the outfits, and she hated us. So as fast as we were signed, we were sort of dropped. We saved the day because we actually kind of sounded like something. And there's no denying that Pat could sing, so you could get past these silly glam outfits. Some other record producer came to us and said, I'll give you $30,000 if you get rid of your lead singer right now. That outfit is ridiculous. He looks like fucking Liberace. So me and the other two guys are like, Oh no, we better stick with this, because we were hating music at the time anyways. It turned out that the guy was the guy that put together Limp Bizkit. At that time, if you were putting on fluff and stuff, you were just a joke. So we were like a joke. Started as a joke, yeah. Still a joke. Did it.
You're gonna get that inked.
Yeah.
It's fucking paper.
It's gonna hurt.
So if I get that cover next time, you're gonna remember me, right?
Yeah.
How could you forget that?
If you get it inked, I'll put you on the next cover.
Psychotica, Pat Briggs. Bring it home again to Chicago. I love you. I love everything about you. I love everything about your band. Why don't you bring your happy ass back to Chicago, kick these fucking faggots out of here and do another show. Because there's no more fucking queer motherfuckers doing gay ass shows here doing shit. Come here, play some good music. I mean, in a non-homosexual way. Come here, play some good fucking music. Like Psychotica. Dude, fuck this shit.
I've always been that way. I mean, I was like dressing in my grandmother's clothes when I was a little kid. I don't know what to say about that, you know.
And you've never had any backlash for it? Or?
I never let it be a problem. It's all depends on how you perceive it. Some people do that to get a reaction out of people. I don't do it for that reason anymore. I did when I was younger, I think. I just do it because that's who I am. You know, some people fall right into that, and like they'll get dressed up, and then people will give them the reaction that they want, and then they're angry about it. I always liken it to a clown rather than a drag queen. I kind of see myself more as a modern-day clown.
Thank you so much for the years of music that you've brought to us. I mean, even though you went away for a little while, thank you. I mean, you have no idea what your art means to me. I mean, it is art. It's not just music. It's something more. It's an experience unto itself. Thank you for bringing that to us. And more importantly, thanks for, you know, letting your art touch me.
For a bunch of quarters?
We're at 30 minutes of quarters.
30, 60. It takes anything? 2 hours. Note. He said, I'm sorry, I had to go. And at the end of the night, I'd have to go collect the money. So I had to chase these fuckers down. Look, dude, give me the money. Like, this would happen every night. And I'm going, oh, now I get it.
I don't remember that.
I go, that's why the tour manager quit.
I don't remember that at all.
You didn't see it because I was doing it late night at 2 in the morning. You were already either gone somewhere or whatever. No, I tried to get the money. There simply wasn't any.
There wasn't any money.
But in the past, I tried to get the money, and I was successful.
Well, be sure and say that.
Except
on film. That's a good idea.
Where? I think that you should just, if he keeps talking to you about booking tours, fine, just tell him you're booking the tours. But the reality is we're not even halfway through this one. And what's that? And like yesterday or whatever, 2 days ago, our show, we barely got through 4 songs. You know, I forgot to put the stool on the stage so he could sit down. So what happened was is he had to stand up for the first song. But then he just sat down on the edge of the stage for the next 3 songs. And then we got to the 4th song, he stood up, and that was the end. Yeah, 4 songs is down to like 12 minutes. So yeah, just keep looking away, knowing what you know. And then always have an out. So, okay. All right, bye. Like any of these great bands that become a catastrophic failure or a disaster, it's the same. It's like we were a 6-piece band, and then we were a 5-piece band, then we were a 4-piece band, and now it's down to me and Pat. Eventually, it could probably just be Pat singing to a CD, but right now it's still a 2-person band, and because of that, we can almost survive. You know, you get your $300, you sell some merch, you buy your food, you get a hotel, you drive 700 miles, and you break even. 15 years ago, we were making money, but it was all fake money. There was a record company involved, and they would give us money to go tour with no record out, so we didn't have any fans. Because we had a record deal, we were with the world's best booking agent called William Morris, and the club would say, hey, you know, we can't pay you, no one came tonight. And then I'd have to go to the owner and go, well, look, we have a contract, you have to pay us $1,500, because if you don't, you know, William Morris, you know, won't give you Tool next week. But you can't come back and do it again because the clubs are savvy to it. But now what happens is you play a show, you get a little bit of money, which is actually money that you earn instead of money that's just given to you. So it's like rewarding. You get a real justified reward as opposed to what back in the day they would call a sweetheart deal.
Can we make that reward a little bigger?
Today's reward?
I don't know. It's really up to the fans.
We need to make that reward a little bigger.
The gang gang dance. But so it's just like any.
It's all the same.
There's really no difference.
And what's the situation with Pat?
What is his situation?
Yeah.
Well, I'm not really sure. He's sort of the same. But he's got he's smoking, he's drinking, playing music. He fantasizes.
I can't ever remember having, I was here about, band blowouts and these crazy fights that bands have. And we don't have any of that. I mean, we've been doing it too long together. We know when to stop with each other, when we're getting on each other's nerves, and just go the other way and pull it together. And can you go tell them to stop the music? Because I can tell he's starting already. They don't know that he's starting. They think he's fooling around. Okay, I'm going on.
That was a record. Last time we played there, we had two, so we doubled. We got up to four.
But it's time to go.
I don't feel okay, but I don't want to stay here.
Do you want to see a doctor?
No, wait. I'll wait another day and see if it's okay.
He was hoping I would cancel, right? It's a 350 guarantee, but he's losing money. He's already lost money. He's offering to give us $108 plus what was the rest? The walk up?
Yeah.
The door money. What do you think, Pat?
No.
Huh?
No.
No? What does that mean?
No. $350.
Don't think we're getting that. Oh, there's another thing. Both opening bands canceled and he wants us to play an hour.
Take the mic and run.
Alright, well the guy's super nice. I mean, he could be a...
Andrew, just call the guy and get us our... Get us a kill fee.
Okay, now Pat woke up. He said, call the guy, get us a $200 kill fee. I'll go back and pick it up. It's something that I wouldn't exactly know how to do, because by me being there, it'd be like, I think it's better coming from you.
I asked him if he wanted to cancel.
Tell me
he never canceled a show.
He said that?
Yeah.
Can he even walk? Is he still lying down?
No, he's standing up now.
Let's have the ambulance waiting on the side of the stage.
Yeah.
It sounds like he wants to cancel because he doesn't want to open
tonight. Yeah, he wants to cancel.
Well, it would be worse if we show up and then there's no show.
And you know what? I really didn't want to play Don Hills in the first place. I gotta tell you. I didn't want to do it because the club is over. The place to do it would be someplace crazy like the Cock.
The what?
The Cock, that gay bar.
Okay, so the guy wants to get on stage and sing happy birthday?
What? Hell no.
No,
hell
no. Pat can sing happy birthday really well.
Fuck that shit. No way.
Let's practice it, Pat.
Absolutely not.
Come on.
You know that's going to make me mad by even saying it. Why would you even say that?
Well, let the guy know that it's Pat's birthday too, so we'll do a duo.
Fuck that shit. I don't do birthdays and bar mitzvahs. What the fuck?
Tell him to bring a cake.
Jesus Christ.
Did you worry about him during the tour?
Yes. I thought two things. I thought, one, he was very selfish because he's sick and making himself sicker, and it affects the people around him, and he wasn't taking care of himself. And we tried to take care of him, but he just... It's like he didn't really even want to be helped, or maybe he doesn't think that something's wrong, but something's wrong.
For the bears and stuff. All right, that's all the deer and the antelope get today.
Oh, we're missing it.
All right, we are.
We're actually missing it.
No, we're not missing it yet.
How do you know?
Because it shoots straight up in the air.
Hey, we're not missing it yet. Let's go faster. This is the most exciting thing that's happened to this band ever.
Ever?
Ever. I'm putting on my...
Oh, there's lots of them, I see.
Yeah, but that's the one. I'm fixated on it. Yeah, it's sickening. It's the best thing I've ever done in my whole life.
It's crazy.
Hey, did that just end?
They don't speak English, Paul.
Yeah, they do. Did it just happen or is it about to happen?
It's about to happen.
608. It's about to happen. That's a song by Susie and the Banshees.
When is 608? What time is it? You're so excited right now.
5:55. 12 minutes, everybody.
Patiently waiting for Old Faithful. Paul's so excited right now, he could just pee himself.
Here we go.
You think? This is it? Look, oh, here we go.
I'm getting
look,
a little
look.
Something.
Look, Jonathan. Maybe a little something. Not yet.
False alarm. I'm going to get everyone to cheer.
I'm sure they will.
I'm going to get a standing O out of this one, man.
Here we go.
That was it. We get a little better. incredible.